system, in education system, the biggest problem is one human being coming and telling another human being, how many times I should tell you, still you have not understood that. That's the worst thing in an education system.
And because of that weakness, what happens? It falls down. At one time, it falls down. Clear? So that is all about the mass moment on the three cases. I hope this is understood. Is that clear? Okay. So this was all about mass moment. Now we will see how there is. We'll see how groundwater affects. Okay, we'll see how groundwater affects. So the next topic will be groundwater. But before we move on, let us take a 2 minutes break. Now it is 2:12. We will start the class sharply at 12. Okay, 2 minutes break. In the meantime, you make a note of this. You can message your WhatsApp number to this particular number. Henceforth, the notification will be added on this. Okay. If you want to get notification update from me itself, from my side, then you can update on this particular number. Okay. We'll meet back in 12:02. Sorry, we'll meet back at 12:03. Okay, we'll get back. Am I audible? So now we'll go to groundwater. Here, the whole process of the circulation of water between the land, sea and atmosphere is basically known as what? Hydrological cycle. Basically, if I tell what is a hydrological cycle, hydrological cycle, what it is? Basically, it is the whole process, of the circulation of water. In simple, it is a circulation of water between land, sea and atmosphere. Correct or not? This is nothing but hydrological cycle. That is, this is a soil. Here it rains. These rains are carried away by the water. and again it evaporates, and again it condenses. When it condenses, it falls as a rain, right? So this total cycle is called as hydrological cycle, right or not? The movement of basically the water in the atmosphere and its effects on climate are dealt with the other, we'll be dealing with the other day, okay? Whereas with seas and ocean also we'll discuss in some other day. What we are going to discuss is basically we'll discuss on the groundwater today, okay? When rainwater, so try to understand this. So when rainwater, rain falls on the earth, it is distributed in various ways, right or not? Some is immediately evaporated and thus returns to the atmosphere as water vapor, as I have shown over here, okay? The rain falls, right? Rains falls on the earth, it is distributed in various ways, right? Some goes inside and some flows away as rivers. Some is immediately evaporated and thus returns to the atmosphere as water vapors. Some is absorbed by plants and only gradually return to the atmosphere by transpiration from the leaves of the plants. Much of it flows directly off slopes to join streams and rivers, eventually reaching the seas and oceans. And this is known as runoff. So what is runoff? What happens is, when the water vapor falls to earth, okay, it may form, it will be falling by rain. But what happens? Sometimes some of them are absorbed by plants and only gradually return back to atmosphere, which have been absorbed by the plants. Those are returned back to atmosphere by whom? By the transpiration of leaves, by the leaves, by transpiration. And because of which, much of it flows directly off slopes to join stream, and much of them flows as a stream. So this part, so this are called as runoff. And a considerable portion of the water received from rain or snow, however, percolates downward into the soil. Few paths get inside the soil, which goes flows over the soil is called as runoff. And some get inside the soil and rocks. Soils means what? Obviously, inside there will be rocks, there will be plants, there will be fossils. So some get inside the rocks, filling up joints and pore spaces and forming what is known as ground water. Correct or not? When the rain falls to the earth, few flows over the surface, that is called runoff. And the one which seeps in inside is called as groundwater. Groundwater basically plays a very important role in part of weathering and mass movement, and is also important as a means of natural water storage. Groundwater is also very, very important as a natural water storage. And maximum urban areas are dependent on this ground area, which is even less than 1%. And that is the only reason they have been deep concern, because of depletion of groundwater level. The amount of water basically available to form groundwater depends to some extent on climate, no doubt in this. Like in dry climates, much precipitation may be quickly evaporated into the dry atmosphere and little moisture may percolate into the ground. But in very humid conditions, okay, what happens is, I just told about dry climates. In dry climates, what happens? Much precipitation may be quickly evaporated, okay, maximum may evaporate rather than falling back as rain. But what happens in return, those are in humid conditions where the surface of ground may already be moist, but much water may be moved as runoff. Whereas in moderate humid areas, water both runs off and sinks into the grounds. So like what I am telling is, I am telling three cases. One, in the dry climate, what happens? Dry climate, what happens? Much will quickly evaporate. Here, maximum quickly evaporates. Whereas, very little quickly evaporates, so very little will be going to ground. Whereas in humid conditions, surface of ground may already be moist, because here humid ground, what happened? The ground will be always with full of moisture. So already that ground is full with groundwater. So here we'll find runoff, more runoff. Okay. Obviously ground is less because already it is in moisture. Whereas in moderate humid conditions, what happens is both there will be runoff, this will be moderate runoff as well as ground seeping, means water will be equally sipped into the ground. Clear? Here what happens is, more important however is the nature of the rocks. Here we have to understand the nature of the rocks, what happens over here. Like this is the ground, this will be rocks. So how the water will go is this will be filled with water. So in case of rocks, if there is soil, then also it will be filled like this. This is what? These are rocks. Whereas the blue part is water. So rocks and how easily they absorb and retain water, basically.
Download our revolutionary app for free.